what is known constitutionally is that you don't need to have separate criminal clauses. The existing CRPC and civil clauses can be used by the judges in this case, in giving punishments, you don't need to have a separate system. They can determine that this clause has been violated and therefore it has to be. That brings us to the question that was raised. It seems that it is still heavy on teacher responsibility. I consider that is a very important question. Bahut bahut problem hai isko leke. I am with Sarda and you that teachers cannot be made scapegoats of what is wrong with education. For years we've been fighting for this. But we cannot overlook the fact that teacher accountability is also required. Both are required. Now, with all that there, if a child is not in school, teacher will not be hauled up for that. The first job is the school management committee, and if the school management committee also says that we've not been able to convince, then it will be the education department for that purpose. But if this teacher is not coming to school, if the teacher is sending a surrogate teacher, which has become a menace, I might tell you, कि टीचर को 5000 रुपया मिल रहा है, वो किसी लड़के को 800 रुपया देता है और वो लड़का पढ़ाता है और टीचर घर बैठा होता है. एंड दिस इज नॉट अ स्मॉल प्रॉब्लम इन रूरल इंडिया, इट्स अ बिग प्रॉब्लम. नाउ इफ दीज थिंग्स हैपन देन द टीचर्स हैव टू बी हेल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिबल. द क्लॉज दैट पीपल हैव फाउंड लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम विथ इज द क्लॉज अबाउट नॉन एकेडमिक ड्यूटीज. नाउ दिस बिल सेज देयर विल बी ओनली 3 नॉन एकेडमिक ड्यूटीज, इलेक्शंस, disaster relief and 10-year decennial census. This is a problem of another clause in the constitution. There is a clause in the constitution which says any government servant can be assigned to election or census or disaster relief, which is not only a school teacher, it can be an IAS officer, and IAS officers are deputed for elections. Teachers organizations have raised this, but they realize that this is something which the bill cannot do. But as far as other responsibilities, as I said, for the child not being in school, the teacher will not be hauled up. It is the SMC's job, the school management committee's job. It also talks about, for example, that the state should promote peer interaction amongst teachers and give them space for innovations. The bill says that, which the law ministry had actually removed. He says, what is this doing in a bill? But people have raised the question, how to do it? Now the bill cannot say how to do it. It only lays the framework. It's now up to the states to decide how to do it. This question about compensation to parents, if there is a child labor, then if the child is removed from that and put into a school, then the family loses that money. In order to compensate both the livelihood and education, shouldn't state be liable to pay that compensation to the family? Can we actually implement that? Which family will not say that their child is in some kind of wage? And then how are you going to find out that? What about home labor of the child? I mean, we know in agricultural India, 10-year-olds take part in harvest, sowing and agriculture as any adult. And many children actually, if they are not attending school during the sowing and harvest period, is not because of forced child labor or paid child labor. It is family agriculture. Now, if the child has to be in school during those times, but that's not paid wages, what about that family? That has no right to any compensation? So what do you do in a situation like this? Keeping apart the fact that if you're going to add that expense to this, then the total bill is going to be, finance bill is going to be much higher, that will be a problem. But even if that was possible, suppose there was unlimited money, how would you implement this? How would you define the laboring child and then which family has compensation? It's not an adequate answer, but I'm just passing on the problems to you, problems which are with it. The Daily Act, how would that Daily Act, actually this 25% that we have mentioned here comes from the Daily Act. The Daily Act was only for land and other subsidies. This 25% says, if there are no subsidies, it has to be done. If the school is aided, then the percentage of children that it will have to take will be commensurate with the percentage of aid it gets. If it gets 70% aid from the state, then the number of children it has to take will be 70% and not 25%. But if its aid is only 10%, then the minimum number of children it has to take is 25%. If 25% of the children are taken, then उनका पैसा उनका खर्चा कौन उठाएगा सो वन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स इवन विदाउट द प्राइवेट स्कूल्स कमिंग फॉरवर्ड वाज इफ यू डू दिस देन ऑब्वियसली इन ए प्राइवेट स्कूल इट मींस एडिंग दैट कॉस्ट टू द पेरेंट्स ऑफ अदर चिल्ड्रन बिकॉज द प्राइवेट स्कूल विल सिंपली इंक्रीज द ट्यूशन फीस बिकॉज रिमेंबर आर्टिकल 21A सेज दैट द स्टेट शैल प्रोवाइड फ्री एंड कंपल्सरी एजुकेशन इट डजंट से पेरेंट्स शैल प्रोवाइड और पेरेंट्स विल सब्सिडाइज So legally, it is the state. So therefore, the bill says that for these 25% children, the state will reimburse the school. So the obligation is with the state. But at what rate will it reimburse the school? Ab GD Goyal ka school ka to 5 lakh rupee ka saal ka fees hai. To 5 lakh se dega. The bill says it will reimburse at the rate of per learner child cost in that state. So which is the government's per learner cost, jo hai, wo dega school ko. Now if the school is spending more than that, that the school, government is not obliged to pay. Okay? Now this has raised many controversies. Some people say, why should the state pay? But Article 21A says the state shall provide free and compulsory education. So you're in a bind. But interestingly, there is another aspect to it which some people have pointed out, including some lawyers. They say, you are actually going to promote private schools. It's only the big schools who have very large fees which will have a problem. But the number of schools in this country which are private, but charge fees which are comparable or even less than the per learner cost of the government is nearly 65%. Ye jo ye Saint Saraswati school khulte hai na gaon mein, wo aise naam dete hai Saint Saraswati, Saint Vivekanand, उनका फीस जो है वो 50 रुपया 60 रुपया हो सकता है जबकि पर लर्नर कॉस्ट चाइल्ड का गवर्नमेंट का कुड बी एज मच एज 120 और 140 सो इनफैक्ट यू वुड एंड अप पेइंग मोर मनी टू देम देन दे चार्ज देयर अदर चिल्ड्रन एंड 65% स्कूल्स फॉल देयर द बिग स्कूल्स आर ओनली अबाउट 35% सो यू हैव अ प्रॉब्लम ऑन बोथ एंड्स बट एट द सेम टाइम इफ यू से ओके वी विल नॉट कवर दिस 25% स्कूल्स देन यू आर सेइंग दैट यू हैव अ टू ड्यूअल सिस्टम that there are separate children in fee-paying schools and you have other children in private schools and across caste, class, they can't meet. So, gareeb jo hai yahan honge, ameer wahan honge, dalit yahan honge, high caste wahan honge, interaction nahi hoga. So, how do you balance it? What is the best formulation? I'm leaving it to you because it's open. If it comes to parliament, people can give in their different clauses. We don't have to have this clause. So, if you can create a better clause, do that.